Welcome to day two of the 100-day art project. This is the list that I will be using. And this is a 12-sided die because there are 12 categories on here. Sorry about my handwriting. I used to have good handwriting, but not anymore. But anyway, so I'm going to okay. So it came up as 7, and yeah, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So, letters is the 7th on my list. So, I'm going to do a letter. Use my artist tile from Strathmore. It's the series 400. It's 100% cotton, I think, yeah. And it's 340 pound. So I already have a background. So and let's see. I've always been fascinated by the illuminated text. I'm going to draw in a square. I'm using the beat paper. This is an easy way to get straight edges, but if you want to use a credit card or a business card, have at it. Okay, so I spritz the watercolor with water using my spritzer, but I'm going to do a bit more. And I'm going to use the Winsor Newton palette. And see. So what letter should I do? Well, let's do an M. Now I'm not a calligraphist, but I'll try my best. And the, I mean, you can use any letter. I'm just giving you an example. Okay, we're done. Ah, just kidding. Ha ha ha. All right, so why don't we reinforce the border? Now, if you have a stencil, you can like get it from Michael's or Dollar Tree. But I like to freehand it a little bit. Okay. So I'm going to draw in some stuff. And I like the artwork that was part of the illuminated text. So I'm going to kind of see if I can replicate it. So changing the design of my flower to replicate that. Okay, I'm going to get rid of most of the pencil marks using my kneaded eraser. And I'm going to use my Statler 8 pigment liner set. And I'm going to start with a 0.5. Okay. Now, I'm not a horticulturist, so if you want to do a different flower, go for it. Okay, I see. Let's get some more into the design. Right now I'm using the number 3 Cotman brush that comes with the set. I like to limit the amount of pigment I use in my paintings and doodles so that it's more unified. So I use a combination of hold on 1 second. Blue with mauve and your yellow ochre and a touch of water. And I probably will use more yellow ochre to more unify the colors. But who knows? I don't know. It's really too soon. Now, I'm using watercolor, but you can use it with colored pencil or gouache or acrylics, whatever you have on hand and are comfortable using. And the good thing with working on that first and then this one, by the time I get back up here, it's more or less dry and I can work on it. And remember to have a little bit of paper towel to wipe off your brush. Okay, so just do that one. I'm going to use a little bit of yellow. And a little bit of the mixture that I did the tower with. Go in with a bit of orange so it bleeds up. Go over to this one and let that dry. Start with the orange first for this one and go in with the yellow over here so they both bleed in to each other. I want to apply a little bit of water. So once this is dry, I'll go back in with my ink and do a little bit of detail work. So I was going to like do this side in blue. But they don't really, they're contrasting colors with the orange. So I'll carry the same treat here and here. And you can see that it doesn't, the watercolor doesn't affect the settler pens. And one more flower here. Again, it's toned down because I use this combination. Apply a little bit more water here and meld it together. I'm gonna let this dry a bit more. Actually, yeah, okay. A little bit of mauve here. And I'm going to be back when this is more dry. Okay, I'm back. So, continuing with the yellow. And then the orange. Let's let dry a bit. And going back in with the orange. And a little bit of water. Good. Let's go with the green here for the leaves. A bit of green here. And mixing it with the yellow. Maybe a bit more yellow. So this. Okay. And let's get that in there, which is a combination, remember, of the yellow ochre, the blue, and a little bit of violet. and soak up a little bit of the water. Good. So, the background is a bit too matchy with the green leaves. So I'm going to work on the tower here and here, and using a little bit of brown, maybe. Yeah, okay. Which bit more yellow ochre. No, okay. Good, okay. And create a little bit of shadow in the depths. And remember, the watercolor will dry a little bit lighter than when it looks wet. And let's go with the orange and yellow combination for the arch here. Sorry, it's easier. So make sure that you arrange it your paper or painting surface, if you can. To make it easier on you. Okay. And see. Bit more green for the leaves. And the vines. A little bit of brighter yellow. And let's use the bright yellow in here. And here. And the stamens. And a bit of violet. And going in here. So I'll let it dry again. And I'll be back. I want to reinforce the shadows, so I'm going to use a bit more blue and brown. And again, using the same mixture. I'm using blue because blue tends to make a great shadow color. Because it makes the painting recede where the blue is. in a little bit of brown. A little bit of plain water. Bit of green here. And the leaves to give it a bit more dimension. And that's more or less dry, so and I'll revisit the window shortly. So I'm going to ink in the M a little bit, and I know I'm cheating, but the monks who did the original illuminated text didn't have fine liners at their disposal, but we do. And by doing the rounding out, it gives the piece more visual variety. Plus, I just really like doing it. And if you made a few mistakes, this is a way of correcting them. Although, with art, there is no real mistakes, because we learn by doing. This is just part of my process. Okay, so with the window, I'm going to ink in and And let's see, I'm going to try something. I'm probably going to go overboard as far as the details go, but I want to draw in some cobblestones or brickwork because patterns are a great thing to do, and back then they didn't have cement, and it's uniformity. So it give it a bit more reality, as it were. Now, anybody seeing it up close will see the cobblestone, but only after they've looked at it for a bit. It's one of those things you can hide in your pieces. That gives it a bit more life. A bit more rounding out. So this was the day two of my 100 day art projects. I hope you enjoyed the letter M, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.